Hello, young swingers. It's time to get up. It's time to get down. It's time for What? The Nation's TV program. I'm Chris Strouth, and boy, do we have a heck of a show for you, you lucky viewers at home. That's right. Tonight, we've got an exceptional group of musicians that go by the name of Machinery Hill. They play an eclectic and interesting variety of music that we'll leave up to you at home to try and describe. I think you'll like this show quite a bit. And now, without any further ado, here's the big band sound that is Machinery Hill.
Don't care. Uncle Sam was in the garden in the afternoon. Thank you.
You're watching What? With special guest Machinery Hill. So please, don't change the channel or anything, okay? Thanks.
So, do you want to describe your sound?
No.
Boy, don't look at me for that one.
I told you not to sit next to me.
I tried not.
So you're kind of the spokesman for the group here, right?
Yes.
I'm the new one. No, he's the new one, but I'm the one that doesn't know anything. I sit in the back and hit drums. And they don't tell me.
He's not really a musician. He's a drummer.
I'm just the drummer.
Just the drummer.
That kind of explains it all, huh?
Ask Rick again.
No.
Ask Data.
I'm on the wrong side.
No, actually.
I'll tell you a good Machinery Hill story, though.
Oh, would you please?
Yeah, my dad took me to Machinery Hill when I was about 4 or 5 years old. And he put me up on a backhoe, and he went off to have a cigarette or whatever, and I started pushing buttons, and pretty soon the backhoe started going and digging a big hole. And from that point on, I don't think they ever left the keys in them anymore.
Probably a wise idea to have stopped in the first place, huh?
Yeah.
Set you on an idling backhoe.
So, What's a typical Machinery Hill gig like? Is there a mosh pit, for example?
A what?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, there is.
What's that mean?
It's usually backstage.
Slammers. Slam dancing.
Oh, sure.
It's happening.
Yeah, sure.
You know, we're going to try and stay away from these Minnesota Scandinavian references. Thanks.
We were going to wear all plaid, but...
Oofta!
Yeah. We're a Minnesotan band. You know?
No, Wisconsin.
So, where would one see you? If somebody was going to go see you, where would they see you?
Loring Cafe, usually.
At
Riverside.
The
Loring Bar.
Loring Bar, really.
Yeah, and New Riverside.
7th Street.
7th Street, First Avenue.
First Ave.
Where else?
Uptown.
Uptown.
Yeah, we're doing their acoustic night coming up pretty soon.
Well, that's exciting. So now, acoustic music is a big part for you guys, isn't it?
Yeah.
It's about half and half.
Yeah, we play...
Half acoustic, half electric.
And then there's the semi-acoustic part of electric thing.
That's right.
Devil's in the kitchen, taking out the pans. The devil's in the kitchen, and something smells awful bad. The devil's in the kitchen, taking out those pots and pans. The devil's in the kitchen, and he's cooking something bad. The devil's in the garden, messing with the weeds. The devil's in the garden and he's planting crazy things. The devil's in the garden, messing with the weeds. The devil's in the garden and he's planting crazy things. It might be some of that old-fashioned voodoo. I put your right foot in, shake it all about. the neighbors, they're setting up the slides, rolling out the carpet, and they're in for a surprise. They got homemade cookies, color TV. The devil's at the neighbors, and he's watching Jeopardy. Your banners, language, check your pedigree. That guy with the horns and tail might be barking up your tree. It might be some of that old-fashioned voodoo. I put your right foot in, shake it all about hoochie-coo. Well, and it might be some of that old-fashioned voodoo. I put your right foot. I got a 38 special on a 45 frame. How the hell can I miss when I got dead aim? Got a 38 special on a 45 frame. I'm shooting tombstone bullets wearing that ball and chain. I'm gonna ride. On a 45 frame. How the hell can I miss when I got dead aim? Got a 38 special on a 45 frame. I'm shooting tombstone bullets wearing that ball and chain.
I'm gonna ride. I'm gonna ride.
So what would you describe your typical, fan for Machinery Hill?
We have quite a few avid fans that like go to every gig. Well, at least two.
Three,
two gigs
three,
or two fans?
Two fans.
There's three to five.
Three
but
to five.
But one of them moved to Vermont.
Okay.
Lost,
so that
one. Lost one of our fans. Huh?
Yeah, we
That's
lost one.
Bad.
Although he still writes to us.
So what do you do when you wake up in the morning? What's a day in the life of Machinery Hill?
Day jobs.
We have day jobs.
Okay, so let's go around in an exciting and glamorous circle here. What's
all
your
right.
day job?
Oh, what is my day job? I work for a properties management company. No, I'm a brain surgeon that, no, I'm not.
Yes, you are.
I work in property management and run a grounds maintenance department, so.
I work at art museums, bunch of different ones. I work at the Art Institute, the Walker, the new Weissman Museum at the university.
What is it that you do?
I hang art and I build crates and whatever they tell me to do. I'm sort of an art gopher.
So, Dada,
what do I do?
What do you do?
I mostly work in theaters. I do freelance, either costumes or painting, or right now I'm working on soft props.
For like sets and things, or just for fun, like you just come in and...
No, for real money. Yeah, no, it's a job.
Are you doing anything that viewers at home can catch?
Yes, I'm making lovely curtains and pillows for the Guthrie's production of A Woman of No Importance.
Now, why do you guys do what you do? Dana, why do you
why
do
we
this?
Do what we,
talk to me. Why do you do this?
Well, it's sure not for the money. I don't know. Well, because we like it. That's dumb, isn't it?
No, yeah. That's not dumb. Yeah. That's...
Jack can ride, oh, Jack can ride, oh, Jack can ride. Jack can ride, Jack can ride, Jack can ride. So high, touch the sky, could it come down till next July? Jack can ride. Mother for 5 cents more. See the elephant climb the door. Climb so low, stopped it so. And that was the end of the elephant of light and a cool.
should know. I could take the next train out there. If I sleep, it won't be far. But it's so cold, and it's a trick of fate, and it could cut right through. He should know. He should know. He should know.
Hope you enjoyed tonight's edition of What. I'd like to give a special thanks to the band tonight, Machinery Hill. Now don't forget to tune in next time. We've got a real special R&B pop explosion that I think you'll really like. So until next time...